13th person voted out of Heroes vs. Villains, and first member of our jury. Flick, that's 6 votes. Excellent. That's enough. Need to bring me a torch.
So good.
Yeah.
So yeah.
Good luck, Flicky. Flicky, enjoy that shower.
Oh, mate, I will.
Flick, the tribe has spoken.
Sure have.
Tonight, I just got voted out at Tribal Council, first person of the jury, equal parts feeling proud that I made it this far, and then equal parts a little bit annoyed that I didn't get a bit further, but yeah, no regrets. To be honest, the last like 3 Tribal Councils I've come to, I've literally come in with the idea that I think I might be going, so it's nothing new. I feel like I've been on the bottom for so long.
Flick, come on in.
Hello.
How are you feeling?
Good.
So would you like to see
how
you look?
Yeah, let's do it. Holy. definitely a lot tinier. Don't recommend the rice and bean diet though. Booyah. 6.5 kilos. Right now, just been voted off. The only thing I can think about is food. I probably should say like the call from home or like talking to friends and family, but literally all I can think about is food. I'm just like, get me to Jury Villa so I can consume as much food as possible. Then we'll do the phone call. Right? So when I left the game, I had a pretty good idea that it was going to be me. We're in a minority of 4 and I knew it was coming. The writing was on the wall. It is so hard to predict a winner because there's still so much game left to be played. There are people playing very, very strong games right now. Overall, I'm just like proud of where I got to because I kind of just like proved to myself that I am a big social threat in this game and I can get really far again, which I did. But yeah, I'm still obviously a bit pissed. Last time I played, I was the last one to Jury Villa. This time I'm the first one. This is all very, very cute. Holy moly, that's a lot of food. So cute. My God. We're going for a drink first. I don't know when to start. Now I'm going to feast. Oh my God, fish taco. Sensational. It shits all over rice and beans. Oh my God, I'm so happy. Hot chips are just a must for me. Absolutely love them. And then pizza, oh my God. I would like to say I wish I was still in the game, but this is so good. Who's gonna put rice on? Are we having rice or beans, you know? Like, I'm feeling for my tribe mates who are probably like in the rain right now, going to bed with like an empty stomach, that the next strategy, the strategic move. Well, I just sit here and feast, it's great. I'm okay with this. Oh my God! Welcome to comfort! Okay, this is like all the things that I have been needing and missing. Oh my God. Okay, yes. Conditioner. Yes. And a toothbrush! And toothpaste. 31 days without brushing my teeth. Lovely. God, this is amazing. Okay, let's go for coffee. I'm the biggest coffee addict.
And then chippies. So lots and lots and lots and lots of chips. Red frogs. Yep, you're welcome. It's a... He better answer.
Hello?
Hey, Dad.
What?
Good, how are you?
Good.
No, something's not wrong. I did get voted out. Yeah.
How was it?
It was good. It was really, really good, but it was really hard. I'd almost say it was harder than the outback just because of the rain. Other than that, it's been good.
How are you coping after? Are you getting injured or are you any damage to yourself over there?
No, just mentally probably. No physical damage, except for a squished toe.
Good to hear from you.
Yeah, good to hear from you too. Yeah.
Looking forward to going for a surf with you when you get back.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it too. It's been too long without going for a surf.
We love you heaps.
Yeah, love you too, Dad. See ya. It's so good to hear a familiar voice, especially my dad. Like, it's like a trustworthy voice. I don't have to feel like I have to watch my back. It's just like an open, honest conversation. It feels so good. I've absolutely had a gutful of you. If you leave me alone with my little snacks and my bed and my comfort and my shower and my razor, and I will just enjoy myself here with my glass of wine. Good bloody night. Good morning, world. First day in the jury villa with all my mates. It's a good activity to do by yourself. It's reading. This time playing was totally different. I was so excited to play on an island. I feel like it's very on brand for me. Like, this is my office, you know, the beach. So I was stoked about that. This time around playing, I had two goals. It was either to win Survivor, the $500,000, or make the jury. So I kind of achieved one of those goals and I'm excited that I get to experience the whole extent of the jury. Basically, the thing that's my strength, which is my social game, got me in hot water. I made promises with different alliances and I couldn't follow through on all of them. And at the end of the day, I think that pissed some people off. It just happened that I pissed the wrong alliance off and I went home. The next person I think gonna be going is actually Sam. However, I feel like whoever survives the next vote, there might be a bit of a shift up after that. Thank you. Now I just need someone to enjoy this with.
My name is Jai Pattaya. I'm half Australian, half Samoan. I'm a boxer. I'm now an ambassador for beautiful Samoa.
Oh, hello. My God, I have some
how
company.
Are you?
Good, how are you? I'm Flick. Nice to meet you. Want to join me for a drink?
Oh, I'd love to.
I've been so lonely. I got voted out of the game 2 nights ago and literally it's just been me in Jury Villa, yeah. All by my lonesome.
It's not a bad place to be stuck though, you know.
No,
what I mean?
No.
It is nice.
So good, yeah. So I hear you won a world title recently, right?
Yeah.
That's crazy. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's amazing.
Yeah.
Oh, there is so much intimidation talk on Survivor. It's crazy. Like, basically, it's a game of like deception, manipulation, lying, and like you're just trying to do whatever you can to get another day in the game. I'm a returnee player to Survivor, so I've played once before. So I was with George and Hayley. They're still out there on the beach. George has a nickname in the game. It's King George. And then Hayley, her nickname is Queen Hayley. She won. They were pretty much the reason that I got voted out. There was a lot of intimidation talk going on. You know how you're saying you try and like outsmart people in the way that you box?
Yeah.
Maybe I need you to hang around for when they get out.
Hey,
and you can sort them out for
they?
Me. Yeah.
Do you want me to help you out a few moves?
Yeah, I want you to help me out. I want you to show me how it's done so that when
King George and Queen Haley get here, we can sort them out.
So, this is the belt I fought for.
For the world
this
title?
This is the IBF World Championship.
Wow. Oh, my God.
That one's heavy.
So now anyone who fights you is going to be a world title fight?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay, so, got it. This is a jab?
Yeah.
This is a cross?
So I'm southpaw as well, so. What works is the jab, right? That's everything up. So
yep.
If I can touch you with this hand, then I can, you know what I mean, touch you with that hand. So you pretty much touch, and then the damage.
Okay, the damage. Oh, oh, so,
jab, the damage. Boom. All right, yeah, 1-2. 1-2 hook. Natural.
No. No.
1-2. 1-2. 1-2 hook. Jab. Yeah. All right.
Okay.
King, queen. Queen, queen, hook.
Boom, boom,
king,
boom.
King, queen, hook.
Ah, okay.
Ah. All right, sweet. Go. Queen, queen, hook. King, queen.
You're going to get a punch in the face.
That'll do, man.
That'll do.
You've got the basics. You're a natural. So.
Yeah.
Good on you.
Thanks so much. Watch out.
Where are these king and queens?
Yeah. Hopefully in here soon and I'll sort them out.